In Korea, the total number of registered electric vehicles passed the 100,000 mark last year. That figure was only about 5,000 in 2015. So, we can say that the demand for this environmentally friendly mode of transportation is growing exponentially. However, in recent months, public concerns have also increased about the safety of EVs following news reports about them catching on fire. In one incident, the electronically controlled door locked after the car crashed and caught on fire. The rescuers couldn't pull the driver out of the car, which cost him his life. Experts say that this was an isolated incident, and we shouldn't assume that electric cars are less safe than combustion engine vehicles when it comes to fire hazards. But others believe that EVs have a higher risk of catching on fire because of the high-voltage batteries that power their motors. They say that in cases of collision or other impact, these ion-lithium batteries are not completely protected against fire. Combustion engines, despite their drawback of polluting the environment, have been around for more than 100 years, during which many of their safety issues have been resolved. Compared to combustion engines, the history of EV motors and batteries is short. There could be numerous safety issues yet to be resolved over a long period of time. As the number of EVs on the roads increases, so will the news reports about related accidents. Reassuring the public of the car's safety is as important as enhancing their performance as consumers become increasingly interested in the eco-friendly vehicle. Another way to say this is, electric cars have been growing in popularity thanks to their eco-friendly image. So, growing in popularity, when something grows in popularity, it gets higher in popularity. So the opposite of that would be shrinking in popularity. If a girl group is getting less popular, they would be shrinking in popularity. Then on the other hand, a boy band that might be getting lots of new fans would be growing in popularity. So electric cars have been growing in popularity. And why? Because of or thanks to their eco-friendly image. Eco-friendly is another way of saying environmentally friendly. They have that image, so people perceive them to be eco-friendly. The government has also been enacting policies to promote the manufacturing and consumption of EVs. So when you enact policies, you're putting policies in place. You're implementing policies. So the government has been enacting policies. And what kind of policies? Policies that try to promote the manufacturing, so by the producers, and the consumption, so by the consumers, of course, or the buyers, of EVs. We can also say interest in electric cars has been on the rise, due to the perception of their lower carbon footprint. So something is on the rise. It means that it's getting better. It's getting higher. If you say the economy is on the rise, it means economic activity is going strong. The opposite of that would be, of course, on the decline. So if the economy is on the decline, it means the economy is getting worse. In this case, why? Because of the perception. Because of the fact that people think that they have a lower carbon footprint. The carbon footprint, of course, would be as if you're walking in the sand, you can see footprints. So you're leaving a footprint every time you take a step. If a car, every time it runs, is leaving a footprint in the environment, then its carbon footprint is being left. So if it has a big carbon footprint, that means it is very much a polluting vehicle. If it has a lower or smaller carbon footprint, it means it is more eco-friendly. Policies have also been implemented by the government to support the making and buying of EVs. So again, the government is putting in policies that try to help the manufacturers make more cars and also the buyers buy more cars. Right, so we just talked about why people might want to buy EVs. Now we're talking about why someone might want to think twice about buying an EV. So you could say the primary fear surrounding EV safety is how prone they are to catching on fire, which then causes the doors to lock and makes them harder to open. So the primary fear, the primary meaning the first or the foremost fear surrounding EV safety. So when a fear is surrounding EV safety, we're saying that the fear is about the safety of EVs. How prone they are to catching on fire. When we say prone to something, we're saying that something is vulnerable against something. So in this case, we're talking about EVs being vulnerable to catching on fire. If you have a phone, for example, that breaks easily, you could say, this phone is prone to breaking. Or if you have a student that's not that smart or studious, you could say, this student is prone to failing the test. Then what happens when they catch on fire? Well, the doors lock. So the fact that they are catching on fire causes the doors to lock and makes them harder to open. Now again, that's the perception, that's the fear about what is at risk. But we can say that experts argue the risk has been blown out of proportion. So those people who know better, the experts, say that the risk has been blown out of proportion. The risk is bigger than reality. If you have the risk and the reality and each one has a size, in this case, we're saying the proportions between the two are not equal. You could be having an argument with a friend, and maybe that person is saying something that you really don't agree with. They're saying something is much bigger than it is, and you could say to that friend, you're blowing this out of proportion. Another way to say this is, the biggest worry in relation to the safety of EVs is that they are highly flammable, and that in case of fire, the doors lock automatically and cannot be undone. So again, the EVs are highly flammable. It means that they are easy to catch on fire. And when there is a fire, the doors lock automatically and cannot be undone. What cannot be undone? We're talking about the function of automatically locking, the state of being locked. The doors are locked and that cannot be undone or fixed. But again, yet, experts believe the risk is next to nothing. So experts are saying that there is almost no risk. If we think of 0 to 100, nothing is of course 0. What is next to nothing? 1. So 1 out of 100 is pretty low, next to nothing. So when we're talking about the risk of catching on fire, we're specifically talking about the battery. The battery catches on fire, and then, of course, the car becomes engulfed in flames. So we can say the motor in an electric car runs on a high-voltage battery. The battery is susceptible to bursting into flames in the event of collision or other impact. So the electric car runs on a high-voltage battery. It means the electric car is powered by a high-voltage battery. When something runs on something, that means it depends on the other to work. So we can say the tourism industry runs on tourists. Tourists are the motor for the tourism industry. You can think of it in that way. The battery is susceptible to something, in this case, bursting into flames. To be susceptible to something is the same as being vulnerable to something. When does this happen? When there is a collision or other impact. So a collision is a type of impact when the car crashes into something. So when the car crashes into something, the battery could burst into flames. But other impact could be, for example, someone hitting the battery with a baseball bat. We can also say an electric car is motorized by a high voltage battery. The battery is prone to setting ablaze if the car crashes or experiences some other form of impact. So again, what is running the motor of the electric car? That would be a high voltage battery. So the electric car is motorized by a high voltage battery. What is the battery susceptible or vulnerable to? it is susceptible, vulnerable, or prone to setting ablaze. If we say ablaze, we mean on fire, so setting on fire. The forest is ablaze. We would say that if there's a lot of fire engulfing the entire forest. And this happens, of course, in case of collision, so if the car crashes, or other impact, so when the car experiences some other form of impact. Now here we're talking about two different things. One, of course, is what the battery manufacturers would like to do, and the other is what they might have to start doing more of. So battery makers are pushing to increase the mileage of electric cars. However, as more accidents surface, guaranteeing their safety has become more pressing. So what are they trying to do? They're pushing to increase the mileage of electric cars. Now, mileage, this can mean one of two things. It can mean the number of miles on the odometer, so the thing that you see on the dashboard of your car that says how many miles it has run in total since you purchased the car, or it can be how long the car can be driven on a full tank of gas, or in this case for EVs, on a full battery. So if I say, what's the mileage on this car? I'm at a car dealership, I want to purchase a car, and I ask that question. Then I'm asking, how many miles are already on the car? How many miles has this car been driven? So it would, of course, be a used car. But if I ask, does this car have good mileage? Then I'm asking the dealer if it can run on a lot of miles in one full tank of gas or on one full battery, one fully charged battery. On the other hand, as more accidents surface or as more accidents come to light or occur, guaranteeing their safety has become more pressing. When something is pressing, it means it's important. Safety is a pressing issue or an important issue. We can also say battery suppliers are putting their efforts into maximizing the mileage of electric cars, yet as accidents become more common, reinforcing their safety has become more of an immediate need. So again, they want to try to maximize the mileage. That means to make the mileage as high as it can possibly be. But as accidents become more common, so that means more and more are happening regularly, reinforcing or strengthening their safety has become more of an immediate need, so more of a priority.